Robert, recently you stated something about negotiations with Alvarez and Rios. Were you misquoted on that? Or
with Alvarez and Rios?
Yeah, Alvarez and Rios.
Who's Alvarez?
Saul Alvarez.
Canelo. Oh, Canelo.
Yes, sir.
Canelo. Canelo. Shit. No, yeah. You know what? There's no negotiation. No, yeah. I didn't say that. I said that they've
So you're misquoted, right, on record?
They've mentioned. I think they've... Cameron Duncan has mentioned.
Well, I mean, Errol himself said the winner of Bradley Rios meets the winner of Cotto Canelo. That's basically what you were going on, right?
Well, there's no negotiations because we have Cameron Duncan who does all that. And if that ever happens, you know, we have to wait after Saturday. And if we come with a good win against Bradley, then it's up to Cameron. If he thinks fighting the winner of Cotto Canelo is the best thing for Brandon, then that's what we're going to do. We let him do the negotiations. He's one of the best at it. And he's going to do it because Brandon earned it. But there's also so many fights at welterweight that top rank could also do. There's maybe possibilities of anybody maybe from 140 to do a catch weight against Brandon. You know, they just got a world champion, the guy that beat Victor Postol.
Yeah.
140 pounder.
Yeah, 140.
They also have Terence Crawford. So those guys are also possible. They also have Benavides from Arizona. So there's quite a few fighters from 140 that could maybe fight Brandon at a catch weight of 145, 144, 145. Or we could fight at welterweight against, you know, other names that top rank might have. Or maybe at a catch weight or move up to 154. Yeah. But that's, like I said, that's up to Cameron Duncan. He makes those negotiations.
Talking about Crawford, a lot of people are high on him. A lot of people feel that he can beat Pacquiao, but realistically, I don't think he has a resume to deserve Pacquiao. Is a performance over Derrick John deserving of Pacquiao?
I think, look, in this business, in this sport right now, with top rank, he's the only one that could fight that'll make sense. Because, you know, what's his name? Even Brandon got Pacquiao after he lost to Alvarado. Chris Algieri got Pacquiao after he
beat
fought
Provanikov.
Yeah. You know, a lot of people thought Provanikov won.
Yeah.
So I think that's the fight that makes the most sense for Pacquiao. If you're talking about top rank fighters, Crawford, I still think Pacquiao's maybe too dangerous. Even right now, people might think I'm wrong, but I think Pacquiao's a little bit too dangerous and might still be a big risk for Crawford.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Ellie Secback.